band threw a party in the county jail. The prison band was there, they began to wail. The band was jumping and the joint began to swing. You should have heard those knocked out jailbirds sing. Let it rock, everybody, let it rock. Everybody in the whole cell block was dancing to the jail out rock. Spider Murphy played his tenor saxophone. Little Joe was blowing on the slide trombone. The drummer boy from Illinois would crash, boom, bang. The whole rhythm section was a purple gang. Let it rock, everybody, let it rock.
Today's product of the day is Altoid Cinnamon, the curiously strong mint, now in cinnamon flavor. Get yours at Shaw's and Star Market today. Hey everybody, and welcome to DB Cooks. I'm your host DB, and today we're making a simple yet delicious dessert recipe. We're going to be making these Betty Crocker Reese's Bars. So, now let's get started. First, you want to take one egg, and we're using Eggland's Best Eggs today. Crack it right into your bowl. There we go. Now toss the eggshell right into the sink. Next, going to take the bag marked Reese's Bar Mix. And that's what you need to make the bar portion of this dessert. So we're going to... Next, you want to take your Reese's Bar Mix, it'll say it right on the package, inside of your box, and we're going to pour it right in. Then, you're going to want to add about 3 tablespoons of butter. Melted, of course. But if your butter is not melted, that's okay. All you need to do is put 3 tablespoons with the paper side up in this little cup, put it into your microwave, and microwave it for about 12 seconds per each tablespoon. So about 36 seconds total, but you want to divide it into 12 seconds 3 times. So, once that's all set, and you got your egg and your mix in, you want to start mixing it until we get a smooth batter. Once the consistency of your batter feels like soft putty, then you can move it with your hands over to your baking pan. You want to make sure to have it spread out all over the pan, but make sure to spray the pan first with non-stick spray, otherwise the sticky stuff in the pan is not good. Next, you want to put it into your oven, but you want to make sure to have your oven preheated to 350 degrees. Be very careful of the coil racks, it will burn you. Let me tell you, burning is not a good feeling. Next comes the peanut butter filling. Of course, with Reese's, it's always peanut butter. And then, you want to have 2 tablespoons of butter, not melted, but softened enough for you to mix with. So we're going to dump it right in here. And you want to make sure to have your paper removed. Unfortunately, I didn't get to that just yet. Next, we're going to add the peanut butter mix, a package that says PB filling mix. Snip that open. Pretty big snip, but it works. Now this recipe normally calls for milk, but since this is DB Cooks, and you guys know I like to do it my way, we're gonna add cream instead. Look at that. Now we go to the mixing. Now this is the consistency you want for your peanut butter filling. Definitely looks like peanut butter, doesn't it? Next, we're gonna make the chocolate topping for this dessert. And for that, you need the package that has the chocolate mix on it, the chocolate frosting mix. And take that and pour it right on in. And if the recipe says 2 tablespoons of butter, but we just decided to finish up our lone butter stick. So we're gonna add that right in. And once again, we're adding some cream. What goes better with chocolate than cream? So this time you want to add about 2 tablespoons. I think that should be enough. And then, now let's mix this dude up. Now, once our bars are done baking, you're going to want to take them out of the oven and put them on the racks on top of your stove. The air underneath these racks will help the bars cool down a lot quicker. The pieces are made. First, the bar. Then our peanut butter filling. Then our chocolate ganache topping. Next, once all the bar stuff is cooled down, you want to add your peanut butter. Plop it on. Just like that. And if your mixer has a little chocolate in it, don't worry. Makes it taste even better. Now we just spread away. And don't worry, like I said before, if you have a little chocolate on it, that's fine. It makes it even better. Now it's time for the chocolate ganache. But don't worry if it's a little runny. It'll thicken up once you put this in the fridge. Look at this masterpiece. Then once that's all said and done, just pop it into the fridge for a few hours, and then you can chop it up to little squares and serve it. Hey, I want to thank you guys for watching today's episode. If you enjoy, then please make sure to hit the like button. If you're watching on MCTV, I'll have the links to my Facebook, Google, and Twitter at the end of the video. And don't forget to check out my new website, dbcooks.weebly.com. I'll link it in the description. And I'm also running a booster campaign for the Big Brother Big Sister Foundation, where you can buy yourself an exclusive limited edition DB YouTube t-shirt. The link to that campaign will also be in the description. Thanks so much for watching. I'm DB, and I'll see you all next time for a very special episode of DB Cooks. See you then.